Good morning, students, and welcome to today's maths class. So in the previous class we started with addition, right? So what did we see in addition? We did a quick revision of what you'll have learned in third standard in addition, and then we did addition of large numbers without regrouping and with regrouping. So what did we learn in without regrouping? In the regrouping, when two numbers are given to you to add, first you arrange them in columns in their place values, and then you first start adding from the ones. So first you add the ones, write the answer in the ones column. Then you add the tens, write the answer in the tens column. Then you move on to the hundreds place, add the hundreds place, the digits in the hundred place, write the answer that you get in the hundreds place, and then move on to the next place, that is thousand. Then you add the digits in the thousands place, and then you write the answer in the thousands place, correct? Then you add the digits in the 10,000s place and write the answer in 10,000s place. So this is a basic steps you have to follow to add numbers. Then we saw an example. So here, what was the example? 51,324 plus 33,451. So first we arranged them in vertical columns like this. Then we added the ones first. So 4 ones plus 1 1 is 5 ones. Then the tens, 2 tens plus 5 tens is 7 tens. Then hundreds, 3 hundreds plus 4 hundreds is 700. Then thousands, 1000 plus 3000 is 4000. And then we added 10,000, correct? So 5000 plus 3000, which is 8000. So the number you get by adding these two numbers is 84,775. Next, addition of large numbers with regrouping. Okay, so find the sum of 64,547, 21,435, 35,426. So first what you do, the steps are same. So first you arrange the numbers vertically in the place value chart. Okay, then we add the ones. When you add the ones, sometimes you get a number which is greater than 9, or you get a two digit number. So here when I've added 7, 5 and 6, I got 18. So what I did with the 18, I regrouped them as 1, 10 and 8 ones. So I wrote 8 ones in ones column and carried over the 1, 10 to the tens place. Then I added all the tens digit, I got 10. 10 tens. So what I did, I regrouped them as 100 and 0 tens and wrote it down. Similarly, you add the hundreds, then carry over whatever is there to the regroup and carry over it to the thousands place. Then you add all the digits in the thousands place, regroup them, whatever is there to carry over, you carry over it to the 10,000s place, and then write your answer. So when we add these three numbers, we get an answer of 1,21,408. Okay, so this is how you do addition of large numbers with regrouping. Now today we'll be studying subtraction of large numbers. So what is the meaning of subtraction? Subtraction is the operation, or it is a process of finding the difference between two numbers or quantities. So when you want to find the difference between any two numbers or quantities, you call it subtraction. So it is denoted by a minus sign like that. Then you have two numbers which you are subtracting. So the first number, that is the larger number that you subtract as a smaller number from. So the larger number is called the minuend. The smaller number is called the subtrahend, and the final result that you get is called the difference. So minuend is the first number or the larger number. Subtrahend is the second number from which you subtract from the minuend, and the answer that you get is called the difference. Okay, so this is the meaning of subtraction. Now let's see subtraction without regrouping. So to find subtraction without regrouping, what you'll do, take the numbers, arrange them again in the place value chart just as you arrange the numbers in addition. But here always write the bigger number first. Okay, so subtract 24,321 from 86,531. So here 86,531 is the greatest of the both the numbers, right? So it will be 86,531 minus 24,321. So write first 86,531 in the place value chart, then write 24,321 like this. Then what you do, same as in addition, you start adding from the ones place. In subtraction also you start subtracting numbers from the ones place only. Okay, so subtracting the digits in ones place. So here we have 1 minus 1. So whenever you subtract a number with the same number, you get the answer as 0. So 1 minus 1 is 0. Then the tens digit, we have 3 tens minus 2 tens, which is 1 tens. So we write 1 there. Then 5 hundreds minus 3 hundreds. How much is it? It will be 200. So we write 2 in hundreds column. Then we subtract the thousands place. So in thousands place, I have 6,000 and 4,000. So that will be 6,000 minus 4,000 is equal to 2,000. Okay, and then subtract the 10,000s place. So in 10,000s place, I have 8 10,000s and 2 10,000s. So 8 minus 2 will be 6 10,000s. So your final answer is 62,210. Okay, so when I subtract these two numbers, I get the difference of 62,210. So what is the minuend over here? Minuend is 86,531. Then the subtrahend is 24,321 and the difference is 62,210. Okay, so this is how you subtract two numbers without regrouping. So first you subtract the ones, then the tens, then the hundreds, then the thousands place, and then finally the 10,000s place. So you need to know, identify what is a minuend, subtrahend and the difference. Okay, next. Next we have subtraction with regrouping. Okay, this will be easier to explain when we are solving, but I will still explain it to you. So here they have told, find the difference between 72,583 and 31,876. Now similarly, you arrange these numbers vertically in the place value chart as shown. First you write the larger number, then the smaller number. So the larger number is your minuend, the smaller number is your subtrahend. Now subtract the ones. Now in ones place, first we have 3, then we have 6. So 3 minus 6. Because 3 is smaller than 6, what you do, you cannot subtract 3 minus 6. So what we'll do is, we'll move on to the tens place. Now in tens place, in the minuend, I have 8. Correct. So from this 8, I will borrow 1. So when I borrow 1 from 8, so I'm borrowing tens, right? I'm borrowing 1 10. So when I borrow 110 from 8 to the ones place, it becomes 110s plus 3 ones, or it becomes 13 ones. So this becomes 13, and here this 8 becomes 7. Okay, so 13 minus 6 is equal to 7. Then we have 7 minus 7, which we can do. So no need to borrow. So 7 minus 7 is 0. Then I have 5 minus 8. I can't do 5 minus 8 because 5 is smaller than 8, right? So what we'll do, we'll borrow 1 from the thousands place. Then thousands place, I have 2. So when I borrow 1000, it becomes 15 hundreds. Okay, so it becomes 15, and that 2 in thousands place becomes 1. So 15 minus 8 again is 7. Then 1 minus 1, that is in thousands place, is 0. Then in 10,000s place, I have 7 minus 3, which is 4. Okay, so my answer is 40,707. So this was subtraction with regrouping. We have one more method which you can use for subtraction. So what is that method? So they have told, subtract 25,328 from 41,000. Now the larger number over here is 41,000, and that is your minuend, and your subtrahend is 25,328. Now when you see the minuend, 41,000, your ones, tens, hundreds, all the places are 0. And 0 is smaller than 8 in ones place, 2 in tens place, and 3 in hundreds place. So you cannot subtract them. You have to keep borrowing as they have done here. So this is your normal method of with regrouping. So I borrowed 110 from the tens place. So this becomes 10 minus 8, 2. and this 10 becomes 9. So I for the 0 to become 9, I borrow 1 from the 100th place. Now 100th place is also 0, so I borrow from the 1000th place. Okay, similarly, when I complete the subtraction, I'll get the answer is 15,672. But there's so many steps. If to borrow, you have to go to the 1000th place, borrow from 100s, 100, and then the 10th place will borrow from 100s, and then 1st place will borrow from 10s. Correct. So whenever you have too many zeros in your mind, you know, like this 41,000, what you can do is you can use another method. So what method is that? What you can do is you can subtract 1 from both the given numbers. So when I subtract 1 from 41,000, what it becomes? It becomes 40,999. Okay, it becomes 40,999. Then when I subtract 25,328 minus 1, I'll get 25,327. Now this will become a problem of subtraction without regrouping. So there's no need to borrow only. You can directly subtract and get an answer. So this method is easier when you have zeros in your minuend. Now see here, subtract 37,563 from 80,000. Now 80,000, you have zeros up to 1000th place. So what you will do, you can subtract 1 from 80,000, it becomes 79,999, and then 37,563, when you subtract from 1, it becomes 37,562. And now this became a problem of subtraction without regrouping. So it is easier to subtract and you can do it faster. So when you subtract the two numbers, you'll get 42,437. Okay, so these are the methods of subtraction. Now what we'll do is we'll see a few problems which are there in your textbook. So exercise 2.2 on page number 106. So subtract the following. Now first, 5 minus 2. So it is simple. 5 is greater than 2. You can subtract it. So 5 minus 2 is 3. Then 2 minus 0. How much is 2 minus 0? It will be 2 itself. Then 7 minus 3. So 7 minus 3 is 4. Then 3 minus 1. How much will be 3 minus 1? 3 minus 1 will be equal to 2. Okay. Then 6 minus 4. What is 6 minus 4? 6 minus 4 will be equal to 2. So I have 22,423. Next, 92,897 minus 51,345. So here what I'll do, first subtract the ones. So 7 minus 5. How much will be 7 minus 5? 7 minus 5 will be 2. So write 2 in ones place. Then tens place. 9 minus 4. What is 9 minus 4? It is 5. So 5 in tens place. Then in hundreds place, I have 8 and 3. So 8 and 3, 8 minus 3 is 5 again. So we'll write 5 in hundreds place. 2 minus 1, how much is 2 minus 1? 2 minus 1 is 1. So here we'll write 1. Then 9 minus 5 is there in 10,000th place. How much is 9 minus 5? It is 4. So 92,897 minus 51,345 is equal to 41,552. Alright, so this was question number 2. Now moving on to question number 3. 57,623 minus 21,354. Okay, 3 minus 4. Now 3 is smaller than 4. So what we'll do, we'll borrow from the 10th place. So this becomes 1 and this 3 becomes 13. So 13 minus 4. How much is 13 minus 4? It will be 9. Okay, so write 9 here in 1's place. Then 1 minus 5. Can you do 1 minus 5? No. So we'll borrow from 100's place. So in 100's place, we have 6. So that 6 becomes 5 and this becomes 11. What is 11 minus 5? 11 minus 5 will be 6. Okay, so that is 6. Then 5 minus 3 is easy to do. So that is 2. Then 7 minus 1 is 8. And 5 minus 2 is 3. So your answer is 38,269. Now, 0 minus 5. Can you do 0 minus 5? We can't do 0 minus 5. Then to borrow from 10th place, 10th place also has 0. So you can't borrow. So what you'll do, you'll move on to 100th place. Now I'll borrow from 100th place. So this 4 will become 3. So I'll borrow to 10th place. So this becomes 10. Now I need to borrow to 1's place, right? So I'll this 10 will become 9. And this 0 will become 10. So 10 minus 5. How much is 10 minus 5? It will be 5. Then 9 minus 8. 9 minus 8 is 1. 3 minus 3. What is 3 minus 3? It will be 0. Okay, then 2 minus 4. Again, 2 is smaller than 4. So I can't subtract. So this 6 becomes 5. So I'll borrow from 10,000's place. And this 2 becomes 12. So 12 minus 4 will be 8. And 5 minus 2 is 3. So 38,015. Okay, so 38,015 is the answer for question number D. Now, question number E. Can you do 3 minus 6 here? We can't do it because 3 is smaller than 6. So what I'll do, I'll borrow 110 from 5. So 5 becomes 4 and this 3 becomes 13 ones. So how much is 13 minus 6? 13 minus 6 is equal to 7. Then, so 4 minus 7. I can't do 4 minus 7. So what I'll do, I'll borrow from 100th place. 100th place, 4 is there. So that becomes 3. And this 4 over here becomes 14. So 14 minus 7 will be 7 itself. Okay. And 3 minus 4. Again, I cannot do 3 minus 4. So I'll borrow 1 from 1000th from 1000th place. So 8 becomes 7. And this 3 becomes 13. So 13 minus 4 here again is 9. So 13 minus 4 is 9. Okay. Then 7 minus 9. I can't subtract 7 minus 9. So what I'll do, I'll borrow from 10,000th place. So 4 is there in 10,000th place. So that becomes 3. And the 7 which is there in 1000th place becomes 17. So 17 minus 9. How much is 17 minus 9? It is 8. And then last in 10,000th place, we have 3 minus 3. So what is 3 minus 3 equal to? It is equal to 0. So our answer here is 8,977. Alright, 8,977. Then the last problem. 35,580 minus 23,695. So 0 minus 5. Can we do 0 minus 5? 0 is smaller than 5. So we can't do it. So what we'll do? We will borrow 110 from 10th place. So 10th place we have 8. So that becomes 7. And the 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. Then 7 minus 9. I can't do 7 minus 9. So what I'll do? I'll borrow from 100th place. So 5 is there in 100th place. So that becomes 4. And this 7 becomes 17. Now how much is 17 minus 9? 17 minus 9 is 8. So write 8 in 10th place. Then 4 minus 6. We cannot do 4 minus 6. So I'll borrow from 1000th place. So 4 becomes 3 here. And this 4 becomes 14. So 14 minus 6. How much is 14 minus 6? It is 8. Okay, then 3 minus 3 is there in 1000th place. 3 minus 3 will be 0. And in 10,000th place, I have the digits 3 minus 2. So how much is 3 minus 2? 3 minus 2 is 1. So what's your answer for the F question? It is 10,885. 10,885. Alright, so this was subtraction of numbers with regrouping and without regrouping. Okay, in question number 2, they have told to find the difference and they've given you 6 questions. Now, here what you have to do is you have to solve these problems in your notebooks. Okay, so find these problems in, solve these problems in your notebooks. That is question 2, A, B, C, D, E, and F. These 6 problems are for your homework today, which you have to do in your class works. Okay, in your classwork books. Alright, so this was addition and subtraction. In the next class, we will do estimating sum and difference. So you'll have studied what is rounding of numbers, right? So based on that, we will be studying estimating sum and difference. Alright, thank you students. I will see you all in the next class. Bye.